Good morning, dear students. Welcome back to the Maths class. Dear students, in the last class, we have started exercise 1 in relations and functions. Already, I explained to you the problems which are available in problem number 1. So, those problem number 1 problems completely based on the relations. They will give one relation, and the relation is satisfied the reflexive relation, symmetric relation, and transfer relation are not. Already, we show that how was it is satisfied those three relations, how it was not satisfied those three relations already in the last class we have discussed. Now I am going to explain the second problem. So let's see first. So that the relation in the set R of real numbers defined as R equals to A comma B, such that A less than or equal to B square, is neither reflexive nor symmetric nor transitive. It is simply given that one relation is given. That relation is defined like this: R is equals to A comma B such that A is less than or equal to B square is given. So this is not a reflexive relation, not symmetric, not transitive. We need to prove this. So first let's see. In the previous problem, just we have seen that only the theoretical statements only. Here just some expressions are given. Based on this expression, we have to prove the this relation is reflexive, symmetric or transitive or not. First let's see reflexive relation. Reflexive relation. So reflexive relation defines that in a set element, each element is related to itself only. That's why, suppose I consider A is an element, this element is related to itself. A comma A is belongs to R only. So like this, we have to take one element. But here, one see, A less than or equal to condition is given. A less than or equal to, in place of B, we have A. So that's why it is A square. Okay, A less than or equal to A square is a false statement because it is a false because I consider that 1 by 2 and 1 by 2 belongs to R, then 1 by 2 is less than or equal to 1 by 2 whole square. So this gives 1 by 2 is less than or equal to 1 by 4. So here 1 by 4 value is always less than 1 by 2, right? So, but here the condition is not satisfied. So, this value is 0.5 and this value is 0.25. Right? So, this is greater than this number. Right? So, that's why this condition is not satisfied. So, that's why R is not a reflexive relation. Clear? Next. So, simply you can say that R is not reflexive. Not reflexive. Clear? Next. Symmetric function. Symmetric relation. Symmetric relation depends that A comma B is belongs to R and B comma A is belongs to R. Okay? Now let's see this statement. Suppose first I consider A less than or equal to B square is the condition. So first one example, 1 comma 4 I consider. Okay, this reverse is 4 comma 1. Now apply this condition, A less than or equal to B. Now 1 less than or equal to 4 square, in the same way here 4 less than or equal to 1 square. Right, here 1 less than or equal to 4 square is correct, this statement. But 4 less than or equal to 1 square, this is a wrong statement because here it is 4 is less than or equal to 1. So this is wrong because 1 is always less than 4, but the condition is in a reverse order. So that's why this is not a symmetric relation. So finally we conclude that. So here we can conclude like this: A is less than or equal to B square, but B is less than or equal to A square is a false statement. Is false statement because already you see the example that is not work. So next, this one we can conclude that R is not a symmetric relation. R is not symmetric relation. Okay, next we go for transitive relation. Transitive relation. Okay. Transitive relation defines that A comma B belongs to R and B comma C belongs to R. Then A comma C belongs to R. This is the definition of transitive relation, actually. Right? So now take the condition. So here it is A less than or equal to B square and B less than or equal to C square. And finally it gives A is less than or equal to C square. Based on this definition, we can apply this condition. Now take the example for this. So A comma B first I take 3 comma 2 and B comma C 2 comma 1.5 I consider. Okay? 1.5. So here this example is very very important. So listen here clearly. So here A is less than or equal to B square. 3 is less than or equal to B value is 2. 2 square means here is 4. Next, B is how much? 2 is less than or equal to C value is 1.5. So 1.5 whole square. Next, this condition must be A is less than or equal to C square. It is worked or not. So 3, A value is 3 is less than C value is how much? 1.5. So 1.5 whole square it is. So it means 3 is less than or equal to 1.5 and 2.25. Right? The condition 3 is less than or equal to 2.25, it is wrong. This condition is false statement. This is a false because 3 is greater than 2.25. Right? So that's why A is less than or equal to C square is a false statement. So finally we say that R is not a transitive relation also. So we have proven now. So finally what they are, the question is, this R relation is neither reflexive nor symmetric nor transitive. So based on the definitions we can prove like this. Okay, so in this same way, question problem number 2 you can solve, that is your homework. So next, I am going to explain problem number 4 1c. Problem number 4 also same method. Just here this exercise completely depends upon these relations only. If you are strong with these definitions of relations, you won't get any problems. Otherwise, you will face some other difficulties, so go through the definitions. Now let's see the fourth problem is, so that the relation R is defined as R equals to A comma B, such that A less than or equal to B is a reflexive and transitive but not a symmetric relation. So here directly given that one relation is given and it is only reflexive and transitive but not a symmetric. How it works, we need to prove that. So this is the solution of fourth one. The given relation R is equals to A comma B is such that A less than or equal to B. This is the relation in the given problem. Okay, first we are going to check reflexive. This relation is reflexive relation or not. So in the reflexive relation, each element is related to itself only. So A comma A belongs to R. That means according to this condition, A is less than or equal to A only. Right? It is right or wrong one C. Suppose I consider 2 and 2. This belongs to R. That means 2 is less than or equal to 2. Yes. Each element is equal to itself or not. So that's why this statement is a true statement. It is true. So R is a reflexive relation. R is reflexive. Right? Next year. But not symmetric. One see. Symmetric or not. The given argument is not a symmetric relation, but how it works we need to know. So here symmetric relation represents that A comma B belongs to R and B comma A belongs to R. So here A comma B belongs to R and B comma A belongs to R. Now the conditions. So here here A less than or equal to T and B less than or equal to A. Now take one example for this 2 and 3. 2 is less than or equal to 3 and 3 is less than or equal to 2. According to this order way, we can write like this. Right? 2 less than or equal to 3, okay, it is correct statement. But 3 less than or equal to 2 is not a correct statement. So here we can say that 3 comma 2 is not, does not belong to R. So it is does not belong to R means R is not a symmetric relation. We can simply say that R is not a symmetric relation. Right? Here this condition is not satisfied. 3, the meaning of this one is 3 is equals to 2 or 3 less than 2. 3 is equals to 2, never possibilities. 3 less than 2 is also not possible. So that's why 3 comma 2 is does not belong to R, then R is not a symmetric relation. Clear? Next one is transitive relation. Next is the transitive relation. Here R is not symmetric. Next, transitive relation says that if A comma B belongs to R and B comma C belongs to R, finally A comma C belongs to R. This is the definition actually. So under this condition, A is less than or equal to B and B is less than or equal to A, C, then finally A is less than or equal to C. With the example, we'll check if it is transitive relation or not. So I consider that suppose 2 comma 3 and 3 comma 4 I consider. Okay, A, B and B, C. Now substitute this values in here. 2 is less than or equal to 4 and 4 is less than, sorry, 2 less than or equal to 3 and 3 less than or equal to 4. So A less than or equal to C or not. A value is 2. So 2 less than or equal to C value is 4. Yes, this condition is satisfied. So that's why the given relation R is reflexive and transitive but not symmetric relation. In this way we can throw this problem. Clear? So fifth problem is a homework. In this same model, so you have to solve at your home. So if you have basic idea about the definitions of relations, you can easily solve this kind of problems. Okay? Another one, I am going to explain one C. So sixth problem here it is. This is different, little different. It's very simple problem as compared to the previous. So that the relation R in the set 1, 2, 3 given by R relation is 1, 2 and 2, 1 is symmetric but neither reflexive nor transitive. R in the given one relation R is equals to 1, 2 and 2, 1. This is the relation we given already. So simply they are asking that it is a symmetric relation but not reflexive and transitive. Okay? So let's see, first we are going to check out the reflexive relation. Reflexive relation. So reflexive relation means the element is just mapped with itself only. Actually the elements, suppose A can say 1, 2, 3 they given. So this relation must contain 1, 1, 2, 2 and 3, 3. Then the relation is said to be a reflexive relation. So like this, order pairs are not available in this relation. So that's why R is not a reflexive. So A comma A does not belong to R here. Okay? A comma A does not belong to R. So that's why R is not a reflexive relation. Not reflexive relation. Okay? Next, another one is, it is not neither reflexive and nor transitive. Okay? We should show that it is a symmetric relation. So once we check that symmetric relation or not. Okay, symmetric relation. So symmetric relation definition is A comma B belongs to R and then become A is also equivalent to R only. Okay. So in this way, the odd pairs of available in this relation are not. So already given 1, 2, 1 pair is given. So 1, 2, reverse order is 2, 1. Yes, this one available, 2, 1. So if we consider 2, 1, we should have 1 and 1, 2. Yes, this is also available in this set. So that's why R is a symmetric relation. Okay, next one more we need to prove. It is not a transitive relation. It's not a transitive relation. So let's see. Transitive relation means what? Suppose A and B belongs to R and B comma C belongs to R and F and then A comma C belongs to R. Okay? So now see this. Elements available in the relation. A comma B means 1, 2 belongs to R. Okay. 1, 2 belongs to R. Next, B comma C, it means 2, 1 also belongs to R. And then A comma C is belongs to R. Here based on this condition 1, 1. So finally A comma C is 1, 1. 1, 1 is not available in this set. Right? This order pair is not available in this relation. So that's why R is not a transitive relation. Finally conclude that R is neither reflexive nor transitive, but it is a symmetric relation. Right? So in this way you can solve all the problems. Just this exercise completely depends upon the definitions of relations only. Yes, reflexive relation, symmetric relation and transitive relation and equivalence relation. Right? In our seventh problem onwards, you have based on the equivalence relations problems. So if you know the equivalence relation definition, we can easily solve that. Right? So equivalence relation definition is if the relation is satisfied these three relations, means reflexive, symmetric and transitive, then the relation is set in a equivalence relation. So the students, your homework is 3, 5 and 7 problems. Just all these problems based on what I explained in the last session and this session depends upon these problems only. So 3, 5 and 7 you have to solve by your own. Okay, if any doubts you can contact me. I will clarify each and everything. Okay.